Hello everyone and welcome back to another First Impressions. Today we're looking at WeekPlan. Before we dive in, I just wanted to say a big thank you to Skillshare who have kindly sponsored today's video. For those who don't know, Skillshare is an online learning platform with thousands of classes ranging from design, business, technology and more. I'm a fan of it and have been using it as a teaching platform for a while and it's great. So you guys can check out their premium memberships giving you unlimited access to all the classes to help you improve your skills. And it's affordable too with an annual plan being as little as $10 a month. The first 500 people will get 2 months free Skillshare trial, meaning you'll access all of my classes. We've got 7 with one more coming soon, a tick-tick one, so do stay tuned. Thanks to Skillshare again for sponsoring today's video. So guys, let's dive in to first impressions on WeekPlan. Now, what's quite exciting about this application is it's been out for a while. It just sort of had a rejig. And as you can see on the homepage here, the sort of kicker is it's a priority planner for effective people. Now, they claim they have 420,000 users. It's currently available on iOS, Android, Chrome, Windows, Chrome extension. They also have an Inbox Zero Progress extension and a new tab extension. So let's dive into this application today. I'm really looking forward to showing you around this experience. So all I'm going to do is go to login. I've got a WeekPlan account, which I've been sort of toying around with for you guys. And of course, I will be demonstrating how this works today. Now, just to give you a bit of an indication on pricing, now it does have a free trial. I believe it's 14-day free trial. They have 2 core accounts, and you've got the Pro account, which is $2 per month, and you've got a $3 account, which is the Ultimate plan, which we're demonstrating today. Now, I will show you around a bit more detail of this application, but we can dive back into pricing near the end of this feature. So here we are with WeekPlan, and we're going to start with the planner element. Now you can see from the top up here that you've got different experiences in your WeekPlan account. You've got vision, everything starting from vision to objectives to weekly reviews to your journal. But in this case, we're actually going to be planning the week ahead. So you can see here that you've got all days of the week from Monday to Sunday. And it might be a little bit scary as you get started, but it's actually quite a simple process. So we are on Thursday, so that's why this is opened up like so. And of course, it's transferred some of the tasks that I had from last week. Hence, you'll be seeing a really belated prepare Valentine's Day meal. And I actually did that one. And as you can see, once you tick off an item, you can see it completed below there. Now, of course, I need to write an article still, so actually this item can be moved to tomorrow. So as you can see, if I click into tomorrow, tomorrow's task is write an article. Now, maybe I want to record the Patreon video on Sunday. As you can see here, I've moved it across. But if I want to add any new task, I can simply press this add task to the day. And this is quite nice. This is really easy to do. For example, let's say I wanted to record YouTube, because I am. As you can see, you can mark it as important. So for example, I need this as important. It's not urgent, so you can actually tag it as urgent if you wanted to. You can give it a role as well. So for example, in this case, I've created an area. I call this a role. They call this a role of YouTube. So you can see I've given it almost a project title. And also you can assign it to an objective. So that comes a little later. We'll describe how to use the vision and objective sections. So if I hit save, you can see that I've created a new item. And of course, it's colorized itself in the YouTube projects area, which is quite nice. So you can see, you can start to begin to see this schedule of tasks that you need to do. For example, tomorrow, I need to record one module of the course that I'm creating. So I'm going to say that's urgent as well, and I'm going to give it a role of work. Now, if I press save, it will obviously come up differently. The red text indicates that it's urgent, and it will give you a bit more of an indication. Now, you're probably wondering, what does this left-hand side mean? This actually allows you to plan high-impact tasks. So, for example, across the week, let's say you've picked up a few high-impact tasks, like, book doctors, stuff that really needs to get done, and you can add subtasks to it. But let's say you've got a few here. Let's say I've got Notion and book doctors. I'm going to drag these in so you can see anytime it can be completed during the day. And in this case, I've dragged the Notion course here. I'm going to drag it to the top there as well. And they're high impact tasks. They're tasks that are going to be dramatic to your day. So for example, I've just added those two there. So you can start to see that obviously I've got two of these scheduled now, and you can give an indication of what that you can see where they are. So it's quite a good way in being able to plan the week ahead. You have this thing up here called a timeline. So for example, these will show events. And I believe later on you can connect your Google Calendar with it. This is something that a lot of people will like to have. But for example, let's say, on Friday, I've actually got, we've got a house appointment meeting. There we go. And I add that one in and press save. You can see that it gives a time-specific task. And if I click into it, like with all of these tasks, once I click into it, I can start to see more detail. So you're probably wondering, it looks a little bit bunched. How do I make it a little less intense? You can go to My Day View and skip to the day of the week it is, and for example, see that like that. But if you're looking at it in My Week View, you're gonna get a bit of a bunched look. Now, if you wanted, as I mentioned, see the house appointment in more detail, you can change the time here. You can add a recurring. You can add a little, like a reminder to it. For example, if you wanted a reminder for SMS or email, then you can do so. You can add it to a list. You can give it a role and objective, which we'll describe in a minute. You can actually track the task, which is quite useful, and give it a duration. So for example, I think actually that one's going to take about 2 hours. So you can see that the timeline up here is actually updated based on that. If I click close and save, you can see in a bit more detail that the time has changed. Now, if I go back into this, if you were using this as a team, you could add comments and attachments, and that's quite useful. But there's also this progress bar. So for example, if I wanted to give it like a 28% progress, you can see at the bottom here that's indicated there. But in this case, it's actually not something, sorry, if I go back here, it's actually not something that it needs an indication of progress. So for example, if I said maybe here, like, okay, I'm actually, 71% of the way through this video, I don't know. It gives you a bit of an indication of that timeline. And you can do this with any of the tasks. You can just click into them and you can add subtask notes and even tick them off up here. You've also got up here a copy to a clipboard and also remove it from the high impact tasks. And this essentially pins to the left-hand panel so that you can see the most and high impact tasks to get done. And obviously you can see this slightly bolded as well to indicate more of an importance. Now, if I wanted to and I wanted to associate this Notion course recording to a specific time, I could do so. And naturally, I can get a plan for my day of what I want to see and a plan for the whole week ahead. Now, it's really cool. And this is something that you can obviously change views on, whether you want to see it per month or per day. If I scroll across to a day that you can see, you can start to see a bit more of a indication of what you're getting on with. So that's a schedule view, and that's something that a lot of people like to do. But there's also board abilities. So for example, if you want to see a backlog by roles of some of the tasks that you have on, so for example, some of the personal tasks, so for example, I put organized list of questions for mortgage advisor, these are all things that you can add to this list, and you can obviously add them in more detail, giving yourself some more notes up here. So these are all the ones per role. I've created three roles, personal, YouTube, and work, and it's quite a neat way of doing it. And if you wanted to backlog by objectives, which will show you the objective section in a bit, you can do, but you can also add these area called boards. So for example, if I had house tasks, you can obviously have a board per that, and you can even edit the board, the title of the board, that all it is, and also a list. So for example, if you wanted to add it to a new list to the position, then you can do so. So you can actually have a couple of house chores to do here if you wanted to. In this case, you can have a parking lot, which is quite a nice way of having a few lists for different things. So for example, you've got like gift ideas, like buy a pasty, books to read, things that are pending, go to Denmark, the bucket list, so you can have start to have some sort of list-based stuff that hides subtly behind this area here. So if you wanted some more static stuff, that's where you'd find it there. Now, just to give you a few notes as well, there is a help center here, but there's also a sorting ability. So for example, if you had multiple users and a specific role you'd like to apply a filter on. So for example, if I wanted to see only the YouTube stuff I've got to do today, I don't actually have anything. But if you, for example, wanted to see all the work stuff you had to do, So here we are. You can see, start to see some of the tasks. I had the wrong filter setting on. I didn't give it a specific user, but you can do as well. You can even search and filter for text, as well as what quadrant they appear in. So for example, urgent, important, urgent, and non-important. So you can do that really easily, and you can reset it if you like. Now, each of the days comes with, for example, in the ultimate plan, is prioritized. So for example, if I wanted to, I can see the urgent and important, the important but not urgent and not important. And you can start to see what stuff you should do now and what stuff you should schedule it for later and also delegate. So once you start giving it an importance and urgence, whether it's high importance, high urgency, etc., it will use this methodology, this quadrant methodology, to actually organize some of your tasks. So that's something that is a effective technique for a lot of people as a way to really prioritize what you're working on. So you're probably wondering, what the hecky-decky is all this stuff up here? You can go over to Vision, and this is quite cool. So for example, you can say, you can define yourself. You can be like, I'm an independent creator, or maybe I'm really awful at typing. And you can add a core value to yourself. You can give it an indication of how you envision your personal life, how you envision your YouTube work in this case, how you envision your work, and giving yourself a mission statement as well. I've awfully spelt that, so I'm going to use Grammarly to correct it. That's not an advert either. You can give yourself a mission statement here too. So this is a nice place to see if you are giving yourself a bit of a grounding of what you're working on and where you'd like to aim to. And in this case, you can go to something called a objective area. Now, all you have to do, and this is for the quarter one, is create an objective. And for example, let's say I have an objective of 65,000 subscribers. I'm just thinking in this case. You can say, okay, key results line. So for example, you can say the starting value is, I think it was 60,000. So here, hopefully this will work. For example, if you give it a unit, so for example, if you're losing weight or something like that, this might be useful, or you're working on a project that has some specific, like for example, 10 clients, you could put clients as your unit there and what you'd like to start and target on. So you can see here that I have 60,000 subscribers here, and you can see you can tick it off. You can also give some high impact task that are associated to it. So for example, if I go back to Planner and I'm like, okay, the Notion course is going to move some needles. I'm going to associate it to this objective and I'm going to move out, and you can see that the milestone appears. So this task is aligned with an objective. So you can see here that if I click in with the key results, you can see that, this is 0% completed, but obviously, for example, once I get it done, if I'm going to get it done in that week, it's going to take me 3 weeks to do. So you can give yourself a high level action plan. And it's essentially like a Gantt chart, a mini Gantt chart of what you actually want to see. So for example, if I run over this, I'm obviously going to be late. So if I deselect these, you can see that I'm obviously late on this target. So you can start giving yourself like a breakdown of all of the plans that you've got. And if you want to show those action plans, you can quite easily do so. So if you wanted a list, for example, you're like, okay, I need to release big to-do list video. I don't know. You can give it also a role. So for example, in this case, it's YouTube. And you can give it an indication of what weeks you'd be doing on. So you get an idea for some of the scheduled tasks you've got. And if I go over to Planner and I go over to the week in advance, there you can see a high impact task is ready for me to drag in and work on. So you're starting to get an idea that this is like really for the sort of goals. The way that you check in on this, I guess, is if you wanted to add another key indicator, you could do so. But the idea of it is really to help you think more about your objectives and which goals correlated to it. Because sometimes we add a bunch of tasks to our to-do list and then we don't think about how they result in the end goals. So you can see here they have a week planner as well, which allows you to scan the week that you've just been on and actually drag stuff onto your plan so that you can organize your week ahead. And then you can start planning your actual for example, go to all of the different board views, and you can start planning the week using the board views. So that's quite a neat way. And then you can go to your schedule and block specific time that you're working on. And it gives you a bit of an indication up here to start working on. So if I press finish review, it will move over to the planner section. And finally, you have the journal as well. Now, the journal is a separate part, and you can essentially add a new entry. I am not sure what that is, a new cogitorama. Apparently, it's a tool for raising self-awareness. It's like Twitter for journaling. So that's an additional tool you can use. But the journal will allow you to keep track of your emotions and feelings. But if I go back to the week planner, I'm not sure whether the entries get added here, but I can imagine they do. Now, a few of the smaller things inside this application, as you can see at the bottom of each one, you can see 3 hours scheduled. That's something to note. You've also got the ability to search up here. For example, if you're looking to find a specific thing, then you can do so, and it will bring you to that task, which is quite easy to do. And the other thing as well is you have got an inbox, top right-hand corner. If, for example, like plan visit to see Alita and I wanted to do that on Friday, you can just drag these in, and on Saturday I'll seek a better phone contract, apparently. So this is a neat way of doing it and something that you'll find some time to do. So top left-hand corner, you can obviously add more teams. You can change the team settings, which is something that you can obviously change the workspace name. You can email into WeekPlan. And that will add a new task to your workspace. And you can even synchronize on the Pro account with Google Calendar and Outlook Calendar. So if you have already populated your calendar, you can have that in there too. So it's quite easy. There is really simple plans involved. They do not have a free plan, so just take that into note. As I mentioned, it's available on iOS, Android, Chrome, Windows, of course, web, so I don't think you'll be too far from finding a really good experience. Now, over here, you can find your account settings. So some of the additional notes, you've also got the ability to change font and detail some of the preferences, as well as all of the user stuff and the avatar picture details there too. Now, I'm trying to find pricing. The pricing options for the Pro are $2 per week, and that works out at about $8 per month. But I did check it again, and it's, I think it was like $10 with VAT per month. You know, that $2 does work out to about $10. You can get it billed monthly or yearly, and that gives you access to that quadrant view, the attachments and the team features, as well as the goals or the OKRs. Now, if you want the ultimate plan, it's an extra dollar per week, and that totals to $16.25 monthly. And that's everything in here, everything in the Pro plan, as well as repeating tasks, subtasks, calendar sync, reminders, SMS, access to data download, and a Pomodoro timer, which we didn't demonstrate, but you also do have that too. So that's going to be a bit more expensive. But again, I really see this application as those who know they plan their week to week like this and who want to correlate their objectives. I find this would be suitable for someone who is maybe a freelancer or a professional who tends to plan their week to week, at least, and that would take advantage of the vision and objective features. As you can imagine, it's very similar to Trello, other applications that use similar Kanban boards, but this is a bit more different because it's more correlated to the week. So guys, I have a good opinion of this one. Only issues I have is that the iOS and Android applications aren't too attractive. The web interface is a little bit old school, but again, you're sort of you're looking a bit more at the method than you are necessarily the delivery of the application. And you can access it on Windows, and it does have a few extensions to make the job better. So guys, let me know in the comments below whether you're using WeekPlan. Of course, it'd be great to hear from those users out there. A big thank you to Skillshare for sponsoring today, and I look forward to you coming to another video. So feel free to subscribe if you're brand new, and hit the like if you enjoyed today's video. So guys, thanks very much, and I will see you guys super soon. Cheers.